that wama ja'alna the na. Why, what is it called? What is it called? What is it called? Huh? Na. What is it called? Adam? In Arabic first. Inshallah, we'll take the English version of it. Or the translation. Abu Zura? You got a book? No, Lafdul Jalala is Allah. Lafdul Jalala is Allah. Naam, Abdul Muhammad. Abba Ibrahim. English. Abdullah.
The wheel of power.
The we of, yes. You say the royal we. Right. In Arabic, you will say Nunul Nunul Azama. Nunul Azama. Nunul Azama. Nunul Azama. The royal we. The royal we. The noon al-azama. The noon of, yani the royal we. Right? This is not to say that wama ja'alna, that we, Allah, meaning many Allah, Allah. But it shows what? Huh? The royal we. Right? The me of the we of might. The we of the royal we. Right? The we that indicates the and the qudra of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the might of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And these are things that are important, because if a person just grabbed the Quran and he's a non-Muslim and he read the likes of these things, right, he could have confusion if you don't understand these things. This is why the scholars, they do not recommend that we be given the whole translation of the Quran to a person to tell him, go read. Because it could be certain things that will not add up to them, meaning because of not understanding it. But rather, alhamdulillah, to give them some pamphlets or some books that, small risala, small books, right, to, alhamdulillah, be acquainted very much with the tawheed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, وَمَا جَعَلْنَا لِبَشَرٍ مِنْ قَبْلِكَ, that we haven't given no human being before you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, al-khulda, to be living forever. There was no one that was given al-khulda, to be living forever. Sheikh Abdul Razak, he's the grandson of Sheikh Abu Muhsin. Yeah. Sheikh Abu Muhsin from the Kibar. Yeah. Right. But he, yes, that's his grandson. But we, right, that's why we want to apply that, right? But yes, no, Sheikh Abu Muhsin al-Abbad, he is from the Kibar. Jazakallah khair. So he mentioned, Hafidhahullah ta'ala, he said, meaning here, that, Afa immitta fahumul khalidun, if you die, will they be living forever? If you die, will they be living forever? No, the answer is no, barakallahu fi. So therefore, فَهُوَ يَمُوتُ عَلَيْهِ السَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ, that Isa عَلَيْهِ السَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ will come to die. He will come to die, barakallahu fiikum. The شَحَفِظَهُ اللَّهُ فِي, he say, فِي آخِرِ عُمُرِهِ الَّذِي كَتَبَهُ اللَّهُ لَهُ, and this will be at the latter part of his life that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given him, meaning his lifespan. He say, وَيَدْفِنُهُ الْمُسْلِمُونَ, and the Muslim will bury him, كَمَا يَدْفِنُونَ مَوْتَاهُمْ, as they will bury their deceased one. So as they will bury their deceased one. And this was the explanation of Sharh al-Sunnah. We wanted to take a slight turn in regard to this point, getting a little bit details. So what we learned from inshallah Sharh al-Sunnah with the explanation of Sheikh Salih al-Fawzan hafidhahullah is those details about Isa alayhi salatu wasalam coming down and praying behind al-Mahdi, and what is the wisdom behind al-Mahdi leading the prayer in front of the Prophet sallallahu in the Prophet in front of the Prophet Isa alayhi salatu wassalam. Tayyib, as we mentioned, this was a honor for Hassan ibn Ali. For Hassan ibn Ali radiyallahu anhu wa arda, because of giving up the khilafah. And as the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has prophesied that, mentioned that before, right? When he, Hassan and Hussein, was in the masjid, he said that these children of mine, should he call them my children, they will be what? Rectifying, bringing rectification between the two groups. They will bring the rectification between the two groups. Right? So bringing the rectification between these two groups is here. Because when Hassan ibn Ali gave up the khilafah, akhi, this is really, alhamdulillah, brought rectification. No blood was shed. The unity was there. So walillah alhamdulillah, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam called him a Sayyid, was there. And this is only to be done by a Sayyid. And he looking into the general benefit. Right? The general benefit. So the other thing that alhamdulillah we mentioned here also in regard to this is as-sukutu amma shajara bainahum, is to be quiet in regard to those things that had taken place between them. So it is for no one to be mentioning anything that had taken place between the companions, to the point that you want to make the other one guilty and make the other one innocent. Tayyib. And what is, you will never find the scholars, barakallahu fikum, mention the likes of this and saying that so-and-so was right and so was wrong. You won't never. Never. But amma those who instigate any this hate for Ahlul Bayt or for the extreme carelessness of Ahlul Bayt, you will always find them bring about these issues. Mention about some details that it is not to be mentioned, barakallahu fikum. Tayyib, last week, before going back to our book, inshallah ta'ala, Usul Sunnah by Imam, by the explanation with Sheikh Rabir, last week when we were talking about the issue of the when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he gave the image of Isa alayhi salatu wasalam to someone else. And as we mentioned, the statement of Ibn Kathir rahimahullah, bringing both narration. And the brother, he asked, who was those narrators? Adam? You remember? Huh? You were the one to ask, where was those narration from? You forgot? No, we're talking about when Allah gave the image of Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, when they wanted to come and kill him, And he raised Isa in front of them. وَهُمْ لَا يَشْعُرُونَ. This is exactly the word that the حَفِظَهُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى mentioned. نعم, he say لما أراد اليهود, when the Yahud, they wanted قتله, to kill him, وجاء إليه ليباشروا, and they come in to give him that name, قتله, his killing, وصلبه, and his crucifixion. He say ودخلوا عليه, and they enter him, رفعه الله من بين أيديهم وهم لا يشعرون. Allah raised him in front of them, and they didn't have no clue that Allah raised him. So also Shafadar mentioned both narration about the one that was being the guide to Isa. This is the one that Allah gave him the image of Isa as a punishment for him. And the other narration was that Isa alayhi salatu wasalam asked one of his apostles, who will take his image and he will be with him in his level, meaning in the Jannah. And the youngest of one of them, he took it three times and he was denied until the third time. So you ask, where was the narration? And we mentioned that it was in Ibn Kathir, rahimahullah, rahmatan wasi'a. He mentioned, amma the first one, in regard to Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, when he, for the person that was guiding them, guiding the Yahud to kill him, it was being narrated by Ibn Abi Hatim. Ibn Abi Hatim, and the hadith of Ibn Abi Hatim is the hadith of Ibn Abbas radiyallahu anhu, recorded by Ibn Abi Hatim on the authority of Ibn Abbas. He was the one that mentioned about the person that came to guide the Yahud to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Amma the second hadith, the hadith of the Shabab, of the youth, that the messenger Isa alayhi salatu wa salam asked, who among you will take my image? And he told them prior to that, that some of you will disbelieve 12 times after my death. Subhanallah. Some of you will, he was talking to his apostles, that some of you will disbelieve 12 times before my death. But who among you will take my image and he will have the level, the daraja, meaning the martaba with me in the Jannah? And that hadith, barakallahu fikum, is recorded by Ibn Jarir, rahimahullah, Ibn Jarir at-Tabari, and this is on the narration of Wahb ibn Munabbiha, Wahb ibn Munabbiha, right? So this was the two narration that the brother wanted to, alhamdulillah, for us to mention. That was them. Wahb ibn Munabbih, and this is recorded by Ibn Jarir at-Tabari. Tayyib, so going back to, alhamdulillah, the explanation of Shaykh Rabi' Hafidhullah, where we left off. He said that this was Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. He said, فَبَعْدَ قَتْلِهِ يَأْتِ يَأْجُوجُ وَمَأْجُوجُ. After the killing of Al-Masih al-Dajjal came the appearance of the two tribes of Al-Ya'juj wal-Ma'juj. He mentioned, فَيَنْخَازَ عِيسَى بِمَنْ مَعَهُ مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِلَى جَبَلِ الطُّورِ. He say Isa alayhi salatu wasalam and those who were with him from the believers, they retreated to the mount of At-Tur, the mount of Tur. Thumma yarghabu ila Allah Isa alayhi salatu wasalam wa ashabuh, yani yad'una Allah تبارك وتعالى على هؤلاء فيهلكهم الله Tabaraka wa ta'ala. So after their retreat, life was unbearable.